Yes, sir.
Will Lionel ever reproduce the K-line Channel Rail program?
Which K-line piece?
The low-gauge K-line Channel Rail track. And a low-gauge track with a pin-plate track with pins and momentum and plastic ties instead of the steel ties.
Yeah, to be totally honest, we have not discussed bringing that track system back.
Uh-huh. On the new switches, you put those ties and that track together.
Okay. If we get more requests for it, we'll look into it more. I think that's probably the best thing I can say about that. At present, there doesn't, from our perspective, there doesn't seem to be enough, a large enough pocket of people who would go in that direction for it. Okay? Yes, sir.
In New York, I dealt with one dealer, Mainland Train World.
Uh-huh.
Last year, Lionel took the ability from this dealership away to be able to buy directly from you.
Okay.
But you're adding another middleman.
Uh-huh.
Plus more money. All right. Plus, you advertised at the Santa Fe. That was my first station. I had around my Christmas tree when I was a kid. I wanted to put it around the tree this year.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, we when the company went to a major restructuring last year, as you probably have heard about, in reorganizing the distribution, and Lionel wanted to get out of the distribution and product handling business, and so we went primarily to our wholesale distributors to do that for us, so that we could concentrate on doing what we do here and put all of our efforts and energy into developing and manufacturing product, not into the distribution system. So we made the decision to, and it's not an easy decision to make, but we made the decision to go through our wholesale distributors to distribute our products. There's not a lot of difference in the price between buying direct and not buying direct, indirect. So I don't know why your price would be any higher, quite frankly, because we built it in for the distributor to pass it on to the indirect. So prices should be very competitive anywhere you buy your product. But that's the direction that we've made during our restructuring, is to farm out our distribution system so that we can put all of our energy into what you see here. Just a business decision.
The second aspect of that is, with regards to the prices, availability and the actual commitment of the distributor to deliver on the product. I have two items that I pre-ordered from my regular dealer who had an account with Lionel for 60 years, and he said, well, the distributor basically told me I'm not getting them, so now I got to worry about going to get them. Now, people have different thoughts on pre-ordering. I generally still do it for things I know I really want.
Yep.
And my dealer's saying, well, I'm sorry, but you're not getting them.
Well, I don't know why he's not getting it. I mean, he might want to. Yeah. Well, if we've got it, our distributors can get it. He might want to look at maybe another distributor, but there's no reason he shouldn't, unless, of course, we do not have it. And you run into that, too. Either we're sold out or it hasn't come in yet, whatever. So I don't know who your dealer is, but they could certainly look at getting that product. Yeah. Right. Gotcha. You should be able to get anything we make from any dealer at a competitive price, because that's how we set the system up, so that it would work that way. But if he's not getting it, there could be a lot of reasons, and I'm not going to go through the reasons that your particular dealer didn't get those, but there could be many reasons without getting into a lot of details. But if we have it, our distributors will have it as well. We have 12 distributors throughout the United States that are in high standing with us, so they should be able to get it to your dealer. There's something else wrong there, and I don't know what it would be.
Are you planning on coming out with the B units for the New York Central?
I'm trying to think if those were offered already. The B units for the New York Central and the Santa Fe? Yes, I think that would be a natural thing for us to be able to offer is the B units for those. We get careful at times about what we should or shouldn't do along those lines because we don't want to offend anybody either. But if there's interest in having that elusive B unit that was never offered, then we will think seriously about adding those, especially for Santa Fe and New York Central. Those would. That would be nice, yes. It would. There's a lot of good sets we can still do. Yes, sir.
Share any of the rationale for the revision.
This gentleman is asking about basically why we would choose to release the girls' train set again. We released it because we felt that there was an interest in seeing the set again, and especially in a conventional classics type of environment as far as the packaging and all that stuff goes. If there doesn't seem to be any interest in it, we'll soon find out. But I feel that there are a lot of people who still have interest in the girls' train set. Yes, sir.
A couple years ago,
yes.
I want to say it was in 2008, you guys had an operating bridge on a wire line.
Yes.
Did that project die or just get put back on the back burner?
The question is about a product we had a few years ago. It was an American, an S-gauge or American Flyer product, and it was a bridge, the bridge, turning bridge, right? That was the idea for that was to utilize existing K-line tooling and adapt it for S-gauge needs. To be honest, I think what happened is when that was costed out and looking at all of the work that was going to be needed to do that, it no longer became a feasible project for us to do. Unfortunately, that happens every once in a while, where we, in a sense, go out on a limb to try to do something special or different. And sometimes we're out on that limb and we realize that we can't quite fulfill our promises. And so in that sense, yeah, we just weren't able to get the product that we wanted and actually at the price that we would need to have it to make it a go. It would have been a cool project, yeah.
We got time for one more, or two more, okay.
Do you know what the legacy system operating coming out? It doesn't fix the single.
Yeah, the 1.3 release. I think if you come to our booth in the Orange Hall, there'll be some guys there who are more involved directly with the electronics. Someone like Mike Reagan. Or John can be the best person to ask about that.
Uh-huh. Yes, sir.
I would like to know that I'm very happy that you got the new OAO software, the entry-level set.
Mm-hmm.
I'm very happy about that. And the alien, the other
airplane
device. Uh-huh. But the Scout has been around for me, and I was wondering why you don't start diving and trying to do this thing
on the lower end Scout set that we have. We're trying to offer something at a certain price, and to do so we have to make choices about where our costs are going to be for the project and how what price we want to sell it for. And for
I know, but you lose a lot of goodwill by those things break.
Uh-huh. All right, well, We will consider that. This is the Scout is from my perspective something we're going to do every year. There's going to be a Scout type set, so that is one thing that we can look at particularly, and if we feel that that's a good area to do that better upgrade, then we will seriously consider doing that.
We'll take one more question. This guy right here has been trying to get us.
2010, that was one.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Do you see them involving two of them come out with the passenger set for that?
The question is about the post-war scale, Milwaukee F3. Will there be passenger cars for that? At the moment, there are no passenger cars that are set in stone that we're going to be doing. But there is a pocket there, I think, where there would be a lot of interest. So I will take a close look at that. I'll take a close look at adding passenger cars that would be fitting for that locomotive. Thank you very much.
You guys will be at the Orange Hall starting at 12 noon tomorrow. I know there are more questions, but please come by and visit with us. Thank you for coming.
Thank you very much.